So my name is George Hatchful. I'm a poultry farmer. I've been doing this for close to 4 years now. We do poultry production, mostly broiler production. We don't do any layers because we don't have the space for now. So we do broiler chicken, which is basically chicken produced for meat. Layers are for eggs. Some people eat it, but it's tougher meat. So broilers is mostly meat production. Most of what we do here is manual, and it's old school. But with my packaging, there's two types of packaging that I do. I do regular packaging where I just put the chicken in a bag. But I also have shrink bags where the bag sort of creates a vacuum. So it takes the air out of the bag. So when you freeze it, it stays fresh for up to a year or longer, depending on if it's staying in the freezer. Yeah. So depending on the type of packaging that my client wants, or how long they're looking to keep the chicken in storage for, I give them either of these packages. So there are lots of challenges with poultry production, a lot of different types of challenges. Off the top of my head, for my last batch of birds, I didn't get very good stock with the day-old chicks. So what happens when you don't get good stock is, it doesn't matter how much you feed them or how well you take care of them. Some of the birds are going to be stunted, so they won't grow very well. No matter what the feed conversion is, you won't get birds that are as big as you would like. Other challenges, power challenges. When the lights go off because of storage, obviously your product that's going to be in the freezer is going to get spoiled. With feeding, feed is expensive. Here I produce my own feed. I mix my own feed. So I get the feed ingredients from the markets and other places and I mix my own feed. The feed ingredients are expensive. So then what happens is your cost of production goes up. When you raise the cost of the product, your customers are complaining because they also have a budget or they know how much they want to pay for a product. So if you keep increasing your pricing, you're going to lose customers. But at the same time, the cost of production is high. So if you don't increase your pricing, then you're going to be running at a loss. So yeah, I've received support from the Youth Enterprise Support. Yes, they came in and I had two structures before and a storeroom. They came in, they broke all of that down, and then they put up, I have three structures now. Yes, so they've given me a lot of support in terms of infrastructure, mostly. But they've been a huge help. Everybody needs support. I mean, depending on what it is that you're looking to do, you do need support. I've started here, but the plan is to move to a bigger location where we can do more. Currently, I have a capacity of about 1,000, between 1,000 and 1,500. But I'm looking to increase that capacity by 10, maybe 20 times that number. Again, that can happen in that space, in this space. So we're looking to expand to a bigger space. Maybe we can do layers at that point, produce our own day-old chicks. So we're sure that we're getting good stock. And then we can eliminate some of the challenges that come from that side. But in terms of support, we process the birds manually. So that means on a day when we're processing, I have upwards of 10 people here, temporary workers who come in. The birds go in hot water. The birds are defeathered manually by hand. I mean, it makes it challenging because if we had technologies that could do that for us, we might be able to dress, let's say, 100 birds in an hour. But as it is, sometimes it takes 10 people to do that in maybe 4 or 5 hours. So just with, in terms of processing, there's a lot that could go into it. With production as well, it's very manual, like I said before. For instance, if we have to give the birds water, we have to go and fetch water. We have a huge polytank here, so that helps. But so, I mean, proximity to water is not really a factor. But if we had running water here, then it would be even easier to be able to do things like that. Because what happens is, also every time we clear out a batch, like I don't know if you can see, but Here, there's not that many birds left. Every time we clear out a batch, we disinfect the entire place. We scrub the entire place a few times before a new batch comes in. So again, that's a lot of water. So that, and then with drainage as well, there's a lot of little things that go into it. But hopefully, we're building, we're growing. So it gets better. I mostly service middle to upper middle class families. So basically homes. I don't do largely commercial spaces or any place in the service industry because I don't have the supply. But I do homes, and mostly my customers refer me, so their friends and family members come and buy from me. We're hoping that we can expand a bit more. Even if we're not expanding in terms of space, we can expand in terms of numbers and time. So if, let's say, we have upwards of 600 broilers every 4 weeks or every 6 weeks, then we'll be able to do more numbers when we can get more customers to buy within a short time period. But for now, we're trying to meet our demand. The demand isn't too high, so that's a good thing. In the next 5 years, hopefully we can be producing between 5,000 and 10,000 broilers per cycle. We can be doing more commercial work, so we can be providing product to more people in the service industry. Hopefully in the next 5 years also, we can be doing more processing. So as it is right now, our capacity doesn't allow us to do portion sizes. But I've realized, we did a bit of research and we realized that with portion sizes, that's what the commercial spaces want. The restaurants, the hotels, they don't want to come and buy a whole chicken and have to go and cut it up. They want to buy a box of thighs, or they want to buy a box of breasts or a box of wings. We're not at that level yet where we can afford to do portion sizes, because currently let's say I have 400 birds. If I cut up the thighs and the wings and I sell them, what am I going to do with the rest of the chicken? Okay, so we're not at the capacity where we can do that. But hopefully in the next 5 years, we can increase our capacity, we can start do portion sizes, we can service a lot more clients. We'll see how it goes. The vision goes beyond 5 years, but in the next 5 years, we're hoping that we can do some of those things.